Hello everybody, it's Kevin Belmont here. So what we're going to do, try to get a little booger, we're going to learn to talk. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and fly from Liverpool in the UK. We're going to go across to Wales, and then we're going to fly across the coast of Dublin, up here, and then across to Donegal, which we're going to land at. So the idea here is that at the moment in the UK, the weather is really quite bad. Like, actually, if it lets me, I'll see if I can add the filters for wind. So, as you can see, if I just get rid of that. Unfortunately, I don't think the legend actually includes wind speed, but basically there's a storm in the UK at the moment called Ellen. So in here across the coast and basically in the northwest of England, so in this area it's very very windy at the moment. Oh, actually they do actually have some wind speed indicators, so it's actually most windy at the moment apparently over the coast, so over Wales. However, the weather is live, so it updates in real time. So I can see, for example, looking out the window right now where I live in Manchester, it's incredibly windy because the trees are like this. It's like The Witcher 3 out there. And it's also absolutely tipping it down. So I did think about taking off from Manchester where I live. However, we're going to go from Liverpool because it's a little bit closer. We may actually skip over in the video, at least in the video recording, some of these locations, because actually fly this full route would take a full 2 hours, which I think would be a little bit boring for you guys. So what I'm going to do is pause during those times. Anyway, I'm going to get on the ground. Oh, by the way, I've got some goggles ready in case it's windy. We're also going to be flying what looks like, I don't want to say a terrible plane, because that's mean, but a plane which you should probably not fly in the middle of Storm Ellen, I'm imagining. So we'll find out how good or bad an idea that was when we take off, I guess. Okay, so as you can see, I'm on the ground in Liverpool, and the weather is not great here. Let's try and get off the ground. I'm about to put my goggles on, even though there are actually windshields in the aircraft, technically. Oh wow. I'm not sure what's going on here. Let's get off the ground. Put my flaps up. Okay, so if your question, like, I need to find out how to turn off the comms. I'm climbing minus 300 feet, apparently. Okay, so this is Speke Airport in Liverpool. I'm just going to swing around and show you it. So, yeah. So in the game it comes up as Liverpool Airport, but those who know the area will know that it's actually Speke in Liverpool. It's pretty well modelled actually, I've been there. If you went nearby you could probably find the bus stop and the train line, Liverpool South Parkway. So we're going to head over here, which will take us to the other side, where we will fly towards Wales. So the takeoff there was actually, very scary. I was getting blown all over the place. Now I'm in the air. I'm just gonna straighten out, right? If I take my hand off the controller, I am definitely getting blown around. So that's a thing. Try and adjust different options on the aircraft. There we go, so my hand off the controls now and I'm staying steady. I mean, I wasn't, you know, I should write myself before I do that really. There we go. Okay, so we're gonna cross the Mersey. So I'm actually tempted, like I could fly towards Liverpool I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna do it. So I'm gonna change plan to what the original plan for the video was. If I just head this direction, ease off the throttle a little bit. So as you can see, one of the impressive things about this game is that the water down there, it's in the middle of a storm, as you can see looking around. And it's even reflected in the water, like the water looks very stormy down there. I'm going to keep easing off the throttle. So if I head up here, this will be the city of Liverpool. So let me show you some of the sights. So this area of Liverpool, I think it's South Liverpool, if I've got this right. I don't generally go in this area. I did used to live in the city centre, so I've lived in County Road in Walton, and I've lived in the city centre itself in a couple of different apartments, so I might actually just swing by and see if I can find the buildings. I used to work in the Liver building in Liverpool, which I've already had a quick preview of this game. The Liver building is not there. I'm getting bounced around in the wind quite heavily the further I come down. I can actually hear the wind in game as well, it's interesting. I can also hear other air traffic, so you get real air traffic in the game and other players. So I can hear another plane somewhere. I've got nameplates turned off, so I can't actually see them. So yeah, this is Liverpool city centre apparently. I haven't yet looked for Lime Street. It should be in this general area. Whoa, I'm getting blown around really heavily. Whoa. Okay, the wind is a real problem at the moment in Liverpool apparently. You can actually see some buildings that they're building there. You're heading towards Pier Head here in this area, I think. So what you should do is you should start to see the docks. I think that building on our left is its model of the Liver building. It's quite accurate because you can see down into the middle of the Liver building. I used to work in the Liver building, so... Whoa, so sorry, my track AR is glitching out there slightly. This would be the Albert Dock, I think, on my right. And you have to be very, very careful when flying here because the wind is very, very problematic. And then you've got the other blocks with apartment buildings and stuff. I think that's the Echo Arena, I think. And possibly the parking on the Echo Arena. I'll just swing by from the left hand side and I'll show you it. So yeah, look at how windy it is down there. Wow, it's done a really good job of the water at least. The waterfront is there, like those who've been to this general area will recognise things. Like for example, that's Pier Head. Some of the buildings aren't quite accurate. The heights generally look accurate, but the actual buildings themselves aren't quite right. But I still maintain that the level of detail overall in this game is fantastic. Like, what a good job they've done. Like, I used to live in that area, I know it very, very well. So we're going to head over the coast now towards Birkenhead. We've got a nav point that I've laid out in my waypoint that's about 4 miles out. So this is heading in towards Birkenhead North, I think. Yeah, the weather is awful. So we're now heading into Storm Ellen. I'm not sure how I'm going to control the aircraft, if I'm honest, because even at this stage, it's difficult. I really wish I also knew how to turn off the comms. I'm just going to increase my throttle a little bit and gain some altitude. Because I was getting battered around there and I almost crashed at one point, so I'm a little bit scared. Turn my avionics back on. I turned those off because I was trying to null the comm system. Unfortunately, I don't know how... Whoa, I don't know. Problems. Unfortunately, I don't know how to turn off the comm system, so you're just gonna have to deal with the radio chatter. So, at this stage, well, actually, I was going to stop recording at this stage. This is heading into a longer video than I thought it would be, so apologies if you're bored, you don't have to watch. So I'm getting battered around by the wind again. It's causing me to veer off to the left a little bit, and now the right. Okay, trying to trim the rudder a little bit to get me some kind of control. So we're heading over, I think this will probably be like Mellows, and then we're gonna end up in Hoy Lake. And then what we'll do is we'll fly over an island called Hilbre Island. So if I just swing to the right here, I think this area will end up being like Mellows, that kind of area for those who've traveled this part of the world. And then we should get to Hoy Lake and we should see a golf course. And then we should be able to, wow, in the distance, look at the weather. I'm not sure if that's a glitch that, oh no, it's not a glitch. Right, telling me to go to, the air traffic controller telling me to go to 8,000 feet. I'm not going to do that because I want to be in the storm. So they can just keep having a fit about me being in the wrong location. Okay, so this is Hoy Lake approaching. There should be a golf course on our left. We should be approaching it. So these are the really nice houses in Hoy Lake that we're approaching now. There's like a really long street that has some very, very nice looking houses that look very expensive. I'll swing to the right a little bit and then I'll tilt to the left. There's a very, very long street where you can walk along, which is down here. Oh yeah, it's next to the golf course. So if you see the golf course there on the left, there's a nice street that you can walk down there with some very, very nice looking houses. Yeah, that's the golf course. You can see the greenery, the sand dunes, etc. I sometimes come here and I go to the very end of the street near the building at the very end there on the right, and I fly my drone, and I fly my drone out across to this island you can see here on my right. This island here, it's got a few houses on, it's kind of very remote. You can walk out to it when the tide is in. It's called Hilbre Island. In the video game, it has a wind turbine. I'm not sure it has a wind turbine in real life. It might be a very, very small wind turbine. But yeah, in the video game. Sorry, I'm trying to use Track IR and it's glitching out slightly. In the video game version, and a massive wind turbine. The street is there and the houses are there. So now I'm flying across to Wales. So this is quite a scary portion of the journey because if anything goes wrong with my plane, I would be in a little bit of problems. I'm just going to ease back on the throttle a little bit. So yeah, now we're flying across to Wales. I'm probably going to pause the video at this point because I feel like we could probably avoid wasting some of your time. So I might unpause when we reach Wales if there's anything that I feel you should see or any interesting moments happen. Okay, so I just wanted to show you this. So I'm flying over Wales at the moment. I'm not quite sure what area for Wales this is right now. Feel free to leave a comment. I guess it could be. No, I'm not going to speculate because I'll be wrong. But, you know, I'm not long across the border into Wales. But I wanted to show you this. Look at the storm. You can even see what I think is rain coming into that area. I'm just going to stick to the coast, I think. You can also hear the wind in the background. It's howling out there. So, yeah, I'm going to stick to the coast of Wales. in case I need to land at any point, and I'm going to continue onwards with my journey. There's some kind of football ground on there. I can actually bring up the map if it helps you guys see. So yeah, we're going to continue on our journey anyway. So I'm now starting to lose visibility, so the further I go inwards towards Wales, I'm starting to lose visibility. One thing I'm learning is that I've picked this plane. If you have a look at the dials, there's no dial that shows you, you know, how flat you are, and which direction your nose is pointing, up or down. Which is a little bit of a problem when you start to lose all visibility. Because I kind of feel like, you know, and there's almost certainly pilots out there who will be screaming right now because they will know how to deal with these kind of situations. I don't, unfortunately. I'm just looking around. Oh, I just found the comms instruments. So, I think I'm relatively flat at the minute, so let's try and sort out the comms. So I would like... No, I don't want to test the comms volume. Whoa, okay, sorry, that was glitching out. Wow, I can literally look and see straight down. That's scary. I'm just going to check that I'm still level. Okay, I'm still level, I'm still quite high. Can I... I'm getting buffeted around in the wind here. I'm just going to change the comm frequencies. A deliberate move there where I want to try and stop the communications. Turn transponder on. Turn transponder off. Oh. They're still talking to me. I've lost all visibility. I cannot see. I can see some fields down there. I can see the coast. But essentially, I'm now in Storm Ellen proper. Okay, the air traffic controller doctor telling me to reset my transponder. Oh, sorry. The track I was glitching out, kind of moving out of the visibility viewpoint of it. No. I really wish I could do something with that, but hey. Right, I've lost all visibility now. Whoa. Okay, so we're actually quite high now. That's why we're losing visibility, I think. We climbed to 4,500 feet, so let's try and correct that. I need to be a little bit careful because I can't actually see what's happening. Also, my airspeed is a little bit too high there, so let's decrease that. Let's try and get down to about 2,000 feet. And hope that gives us some kind of visibility. Oh, it looks like it's gonna... Okay, that's a little bit better. Still gonna be poor visibility at 2,000 feet, and we are actually getting buffeted around by the wind again now. Whoa. Okay, so... Yeah, we're definitely having some wind issues here. Okay, so we're gonna try and hold at 2,000 feet. Wow, what a beautiful place. Look at the hills. It looks like a very nice place. It's just a shame that there's very poor visibility here at the moment. Okay, so We're kind of losing altitude there. That's lower than I'd like to be. Looks like, if I just try and fix that, it looks like there's a golf course down there. Almost certainly. Lots of golf courses in England and Wales. So let's try and climb back to 2,000 feet. Okay, I'm going to continue into the storm now. Okay, so we're approaching what I think is the border to Anglesey at the moment. I might be wrong about this, so please don't shout at me if I am, Welsh people. But yeah, I think this is the corner of Anglesey. Could be wrong. One thing I'd like to highlight is that we're still quite low, so we're under 2,000 feet. As you can probably see, you know, my plane is flying forward. However, I'm angled sideways. It's the wind, basically. Like, the wind is blowing me effectively off course. Also, the clouds are very, very low. So, like I say, I'm under 2,000 feet here, and I'm losing visibility again. So, I'm probably gonna have to drop down to 1,000 feet. After we passed over what I think is Anglesey, it looks like an island, then we're obviously going to be going towards the coast of Ireland. Going across to Ireland is quite a long time without land. I'm a little bit nervous, so let's see how it goes. Okay, so we're approaching Mona in Wales. So where that marker is over there, 5 miles out, that is Mona in Wales. So it's actually the RAF base there. As you can see, there's actually a gap in the clouds here, and you can see the light is cast onto the hills over there. So you can see green hills over there. However, it's very overcast in the area that I'm in. I've actually had to drop down to around about, well, I'm actually just under 1,000 feet now to get visibility, and it looks like I'm going to lose visibility again, possibly, as I pass over Mona. So it's kind of an interesting contrast between over there, there is some degree of light coming through, there's a gap in the clouds. As I approach Mona, I'm beginning to lose all visibility, and I am still getting buffeted around in the wind. It's not actually as bad as I expected, so I'm still maintaining control. I might change that if I crash, but yeah, I'm above 400 feet, which is, if you're an aircraft in the UK, you need to maintain above 400 feet. So I'm perfectly legal here. There's another gap in clouds there, actually. I can't actually see the ground over there, unfortunately, but we're about to lose visibility here. So where we can, let's have a look at Mona. So this is a very rural area. There's a lovely little river, I think, running through here. I don't know what it's called. I would make a terrible tour guide. We're now approaching Mona. Oh, we're getting buffeted around in the wind a little bit. We're only around 500 feet, so I should probably come up a little bit. Hopefully nobody's flying any drones. Oh, you can see the airport there. So this is RAF Mona, as I believe it's called. We could technically land here. However, my history with landings is not great, as you may know if you've seen any of my videos. There's a slight gap in the clouds over there. You can actually see where bright light from the sun is being cast. So this is Mona Airport, or an airport at Mona. It looks like it has two runways. Whoa. Because it's an RAF base, I'm guessing, obviously, probably fighter jet training and stuff happened there, I'm guessing. Now we need to pivot off to the right and continue. Oh, we're going to a Valley Air Base next, also in Wales. Here we go. Okay, so this is Valley Air Base in Wales. We're experiencing really poor visibility here. But I just want to show you what I think is RAF Valley. If I come down a little bit, oh, we might actually get a gap in the clouds here. So, yeah, this is RAF Valley. This actually appears pretty big, so I can see, I think, two runways. This is a pretty big facility. Looks like a train line running nearby too. Really beautiful area. Kind of wish I'd flown here in a better weather situation, to be honest. Probably would have looked a bit better at least. But yeah, what a wonderful area this is. And now we're leaving Wales, so now we're going to be flying across the coast to the island. So it's a 62-mile trip across the coast, across the water, to reach island. So I'm going to actually swing to the right. I'm going to go off my flight plan slightly, because A, I can stay above land for a little bit longer, and judging by the weather, that feels like a good idea. And B, I can experience some slightly better weather, because we're leaving some clouds behind there. So far, actually, in Ireland, it looks like it might actually be slightly better weather than in Wales. Like, if I look behind us, like, that's what we've just flown through, which is Storm Ellen. I'm wondering if it's actually starting to clear in Ireland, maybe? It might be a slightly less hectic second half of the video. So, this is the tip of Wales on the way to Ireland. Actually, looking at it, kind of looks like we're going to be flying directly into clouds. So that'll be fun. It kind of looks like there's no kind of lower limit there as well. Which may be interesting. So that'll be fun for me to navigate. So if I crash, then that will be the end of the video. This is a nice looking area. Kind of looks like there's maybe caravans down there. No, I might be wrong. It might actually be homes. Just houses. So yeah, this is a fun little place. Okay. Just level out slightly. Keep an eye on my altitude. I want to be at least 1,000 feet. I think I'm going to lose all visibility going over the coast. In fact, actually, because there's nothing to see in the coast, I'm kind of tempted to fly up out of the clouds. The only thing is I would then be cheating, because I'd be flying out of the weather system. So no, I'm going to try and fly through this storm. I'm going to fly about 1,000 feet, and I'm going to fly basically through the storm across to Ireland. So I hope this goes well. Okay, so we're about a third of the way over. I might have got my mash on there. I think we're about a third of the way over the coast towards Ireland from Wales now. The weather has actually cleared up, so we've actually got a really good spot here. Beautiful over here. I'm actually really enjoying flying this. There's no autopilot on this plane, so I kind of just have to fly everything manually. The weather has cleared up here, so you'll notice my aircraft, like, I haven't got my hands on the controllers. My aircraft is just flying perfectly well. So yeah, at the moment, this flight is wonderful. I'm really enjoying it. So, the only thing I'd say is that, as you can see in front of me, the weather, especially over these clouds, the weather as you actually approach Ireland does not look so hot, so we'll find out what that's like soon. I'm excited. So I have just noticed in the real world, there's a... I think it's a real flight. It doesn't have the usual kind of player names. There's a flight right above us, as you can probably see, just in the centre of the screen. I'm not sure if I can see it from my cockpit. Oh yeah, I can just see it. Yeah, there is a plane flying right over as it happens. I just spotted it on the VFR map and I was like, are they going to ram me? But no, I think it's judging by the way that the nameplate is running there, it looks like it's a real flight happens to be flying over. So that's a thing. Okay, so we're about 27 miles away from the Irish coast now. You can still see that plane, that real world plane, flying up in front of us, on the external view at least. Oh yeah, I can just see it from the cockpit as well, looking at it. It's just in the center of the screen. So we are flying into some clouds now. So while I've been flying, I have been buffeted around a little bit. There's definitely some turbulence, especially in the external view. You can see the aircraft, not right now, but I could see it when I was flying, being buffeted around all over the place. However, I've managed to control the aircraft. We're flying at about 2,000 feet, so 2,300 feet at the moment. I'm having to fly everything manually, but it's okay. So there's definitely a weather system as we approach island, though. Look at that. So we will be flying straight into this, which should, I think, very much be interesting. Okay, so as you can see in front of me, the clouds are continuing to clear, and we have what looks like coastline emerging. I'm going to call that island off to my right, Craggy Island. I've no idea if that's where they filmed Father Ted, but we're going to pretend it is. It does make me think that if that's not the island, it probably isn't because it's just an island. But if that's not the island, I should probably make a video where I go to the place that Father Ted was filmed, because why not? I've only got one life, so I might as well spend it looking at islands and television shows. So we're approaching Ireland now. We're flying towards Dublin. We're currently 14 miles out. The weather's been okay, in fairness. Like, I've got buffeted around a little bit. Visibility's not great, but I'd say overall, it's been okay. So it's almost like Storm Ellen is overhyped. I'll check back in when I'm a little bit closer to land, and I'll show you some things. As we approach island, I realise that if I look on the VFR map there's a plane in front of us. So yeah, you can actually see it in the sky there. So if I just look, probably can't see it over my wing there, but look in the sky there, you can see the lights of a plane. I haven't got nameplates turned on in a minute, so I can't actually see if that's a player or real air traffic. Probably real air traffic. We are. So the area of Ireland we're approaching, we're obviously approaching the east coast of Ireland. Dublin is reasonably close. I think we'll be actually flying towards the airport there, I do believe. I might actually, if there's time and I can find it, if I'm being honest, I might try and find Dublin. So let's see what happens. So far, again, weather, not too bad. Okay, so I figure we're going to come down a little bit. I'm going to show you. This is the coast of Ireland, the east coast. So we're just going to head towards what I think is Dublin Airport. I'm going to show you some of the sights. So the weather, there are actually some gaps in the clouds here. So you can see some areas are actually lit, other areas not so much. Just go back to the cockpit view there. Figure to kind of show you the area. I'm going to also come down in height a little bit. So yeah, I'm going to come down to about 1,000 feet. It's going to be difficult to control the aircraft this kind of altitude in this weather, but we should be able to do it. So if we stay at above 500 feet, about 1,000 feet at the minute, should be able to show you some of the sights. So there's some kind of possibly a mine on our right hand side there. You can see the aircraft wiggling in the wind. It's either some dirt tracks or it's a mine. There's a plane off to our right there, you can see. Plenty of farmland. The sun shining to the right, the sun shining to the left. not so much where we are right now. So yeah, this is Dublin International Airport. So let's swing by Dublin and just see what it looks like. And then what we'll also do is we'll swing by Dublin City as well, if we can actually find it. I think Dublin City is off to the north of the airport, if I've got my my understanding of geography right. I'm being buffeted around in the wind here, so this might not be my smartest idea. Also, I strongly suggest in real life you do not buzz international airports. They might have something to say. You just kind of casually fly over in an airplane. I have actually turned the comms off in the airplane entirely, so air traffic control, you will have noticed the voices from air traffic control have stopped now. It's because I've turned everything off. I've turned all the transponders and the comms equipment off. I see a plane actually taxiing to take off there. And I can't see any planes queued on the runway right now. But yeah, this is Dublin International Airport, as seen in Flight Simulator 2020. But I'm flying recklessly low. Yeah, just over 1,000 feet in the area. Oh, I can see a couple of planes there. I think one is possibly taking off. There's another runway there as well. So it's got two runways by the looks of it. So yeah, that's Dublin International Airport. So if I just turn my VFR map on, I think if I head north, I'm kind of going this direction anyway towards Belfast, but if I first... Wow, there's a plane very low there. I don't know if that's a player in front of me or if that's an actual air traffic. They're going to be coming into land though, so I'm not going to disturb them. I'm just going to let them do their business. Yeah, they're landing now at Dublin International Airport. You can see many planes actually, there are lights in the sky. I haven't got any lights to turn on this plane, I don't think. I don't think it actually has lights. You probably shouldn't night fly with this plane. So if I just turn off to the left a little bit, looking at my VFR map, Dublin should start to emerge in front of us. So I'm just going to increase my altitude a little bit. I don't want to be too low in case I lose control. But I think I like it. Joe likes it. That's a really niche joke that not many people are going to get, but we'll go with it. So, according to the map, we're approaching Dublin. The only thing is, when I look in front of me, I don't see Dublin. I just see fields. So unless Dublin is essentially what's down here, that's not Dublin. I don't know why the game is telling me that that's Dublin. I think Dublin's a city. So, don't know what's happened there. Maybe it's a village called Dublin. Or maybe Dub does not actually stand for Dublin. There's an aerodrome nearby. So if you want to actually land in that location, you can. Right, now I've got a 60-mile trip towards Belfast. So I'm going to continue making that trip. I will talk to you all soon, assuming I don't crash, which is super possible. Okay, so we're approaching 13 miles off the coast of Northern Ireland, and we're going to pass over Belfast Airport, I do believe. The weather is obviously not too great as we approach. I've had to come down in height a little bit. Continue to drop actually, so that we can maintain visibility. If I look down, I've realised, or remembered rather, that I can see the ocean below me, which is fun. So yeah, it's 12 miles out. This is looking pretty much as I would expect. To this area before, but you know, from stereotypes I guess and popular culture, it looks as I imagined it. I mean, it's based on satellite data, so it, I mean, basically is what it looks like. Very pretty. I just wish the weather was a bit better. I'm not getting buffeted too much in the weather though. Like things are pretty stable. It's just visibility is poor. So I think I'm just gonna continue onwards and just get a little bit closer to the airport. Okay, so we're approaching now. If I've understood this correctly, let's put my VFR map on. This should be, I think it's the main airport in Belfast. I'm hoping it's going to come up with a name tag so that we can see. Let's get a little bit lower. Be careful on my altitude a little bit. Again, we've mentioned how. Well, I've mentioned Robin, no, I'm not sure why I'm referring to myself as we, that's weird. How in real life I would strongly suggest not buzzing an airport particularly low, especially without permission, given the last trip bolted as an aggregate. So we're just going to come down a little bit. It's a very lovely area. Fortunately, the weather's not great to actually view the scenery. But yeah, look at this. You can see some sunshine coming through there. I think there's also some rain over there. This does not look like an airport. So maybe this is Belfast? It kind of actually looks like an island. It's definitely an island. Has Microsoft Flight Simulator lied to me? Okay, well this is an embarrassing bit of video because it's pointed me towards this. Unfortunately, it does not appear to be anything here. I think it might just be a nav beacon. So I'll just look out the window for you. Just kind of swing this direction as well. Yes, I'm not, if I'm honest. Not entirely sure why it directed me here, but it has. It's directed me to a field. So that's fun. So if I pass over this, it should hopefully then redirect me onto the next beacon. Just put my VFR map on. So it is indicating Bell in this direction. I'll just swap out. So I'm effectively 100 miles from the final airport, which is Donegal. So I hope I pronounced that right, otherwise there will be YouTube comments. So I've got 100 miles to go this journey. Right now I've been flying for I would say 2.5 hours, so it's taken me longer than I would expect. I've been trying to do things like, for example, manage my airspeed, manage my engine to make sure I'm not pushing too hard. Try and make sure that I don't get too low and crash. So it's been a pretty full-on flight where I've had to basically micromanage the plane the entire way. There's no autopilot, obviously. I think pretty soon we're going to be passing over the area which it flags as Belfast, which I'm going to guess is actually the airport. So here, down here, is the much-rumored Belfast City Airport. So obviously it's very cloudy. We have some severe visibility issues going on here, but we're going to try and get a little bit lower, and we're going to try and buzz the airport. Here we go. So it's a single runway by the looks of it. Can't see any other runway there. So yeah, this is a Belfast City Airport. It's got car parks either side. There's traffic driving past the main road. There's some water there. That's Belfast City Airport. Now we're going to continue onwards to Donegal, which is currently 90 miles away. So this is turning into a really long flight. So I need to adjust the trim of my plane here. Can I kind of bounce around a little bit? You can see, rather unrealistically, two ships there that are docked, but they're completely flat because the game had not converted them into ships. You can, however, see a ship there in the distance. You can also see that there's sun coming through, and the sun is actually casting onto where that ship is on the land in the distance. There's also some casting crew here onto the ground just in front of me. So now I'm going to continue with the 90-mile journey towards Donegal. Look at these views. So this is just over Belfast. The sun is peeking through. So there's some areas that aren't in shadow. Just an incredible landscape. There's an incredible mix between a massive big city there and greenery. Just green everywhere as we disappear off into some clouds. Hey, double rainbow all the way! Double rainbow over Ireland. Really sweet. The scenery is incredible. Look at this. Look at this landscape. The near Black Hill airstrip. Just, you know, the weather's awful, but the landscape is pretty cool. Wow, look at this. Ireland is pretty. I kind of want to just take control of the aircraft and just go down to the landscape here and just have an explore. So I'm just going to slow down a little bit. Conscious of my airspeed here, it's a bit too high. But I just want to like dive into the scenery in Northern Ireland and just have a look around. It's just incredible. Nice little lake there. Kind of some farms in this area. Some buildings. You can see cars going past. Great little hill there. I'm just going to follow this road, I think. So it's heading in the same direction as we're going anyway. We're getting a little bit low there. Don't want to hit trees. Okay, so you see some houses along the side of the streets. Just such a beautiful place. I can see up ahead. I'm just going to increase my airspeed a little bit. yeah, put some more throttle into this because I don't want to hit anything. I can see what looks like wind turbines ahead of me. So if I look over the dashboard, I think there's a big wind turbine farm that we're approaching. We're currently about 45 miles out from Donegal, which is where we're going to land this flight, if I can actually land the airplane, which, you know, is to be seen. But I'm just really enjoying this flight at the moment. It's a really kind of magical place. It might be, I mean, the weather, like, I mean, it helps that the game itself looks good. Like, technically, this is probably one of the most advanced experiences I've seen. I mean, look at the clouds casting shadows and light onto the landscape. It just does an incredible job with the satellite imagery and the recreation of the entire Earth. It's doing a lot of things right. Tickling my fancy. I'm really enjoying flying through this landscape as well. It's just a joy to fly this aircraft. So I'm geeking out a bit too much now. Let's skip a little bit forward. The wind turbines down there. Kind of a very cool landscape. Look at this. Incredible stuff. I'm so tempted to dive between these wind turbines, but I really don't want to crash. Let's kind of go off the beaten track a little bit. Our airspeed is way too high there. Well, we're approaching 200 kilometers per hour, which is very much the danger zone, but we're under that at the moment. Let's do a flypast of these wind turbines. So cool. Kind of just like the area that they're in as well. Okay, so we're currently around about 16 miles out of Donegal. stuff flying in. As you can see around me, the visibility has reduced to pretty much nothing. We're currently at just over 3,000 feet, so we're actually going to try descending a little bit. We're supposed to be doing an instrument landing at the moment. I've been talking to air traffic control. However, I'm going to go away from their recommendations a little bit and try and reduce my altitude. Yeah, there we go, they're telling me off. See, they want me to stay at 4,000 feet, but I can't see anything at 4,000 feet, and it's kind of boring doing a video for the internet where you can't actually see anything. So I'm going to actually cancel my approach with them, if it'll let me. It's apparently not me, it's letting me select the option, so I'll try doing it here. I'm going to tune into the tower. I need to adjust my trim here. Look, I'm having problems. Okay, so it's telling me to... So I need to tune in. I'm actually tempted to request airport directions. I think the entry is on the left-hand side. It's actually further away than I thought it was going to be. When I cancelled my IFR, it's directing me a slightly different way. So I'm going to tune into their approach. Okay. So they know that I'm... I accidentally hit my rudders then, which would have been bad. I'm going to reduce my engines a little bit. I'm a little bit too fast there. I'm going to start reducing my... my altitude is actually a little bit too low. Need to fiddle with that. There we go. That looks a bit better. It was saying that I was under 1,000 feet, which I could visually see wasn't correct. My altimeter is not set correctly. Okay, so now I'm heading towards Donegal. I'm not sure if I should be entering on the left or the right. I think it's the left. So it's going to be a very difficult landing, because if you look ahead, it looks at least from here like it's going to be in clouds, under the cover of clouds. Might just, certainly off to the right, you can just see under the clouds. But ahead of me, where the airport appears to be, looks like there might be a layer of cloud over there. I've never done a completely blind landing on this so far, so this might be fun. It's not the ideal aircraft to do that kind of thing with. Like, I've got a feeling in the real world you probably shouldn't fly this if you can't see a goddamn thing. It doesn't even have lights on so that you can see the aircraft in, you know, cloud or night. Which I think is actually a legal requirement. So I probably shouldn't be flying in these kind of conditions, is the roundabout thing that I'm trying to say there.
my altitude is only about 1,000 meters. Sorry, 1,000 feet, not meters. Still, it's a very nice area. I'm just starting to get a little bit stressed about how I'm going to actually land this thing now. Let's just request some more directions. Heading that direction. It says that I'm 17 miles away. The pattern for the entry is apparently 15 miles away, so the entry pattern is going to be about 2 miles out by the looks of it. If you look at the VFR map, I am of course approaching from the wrong angle for my flight plan, but you know, live and learn. So I'm just going to adjust the trim a little bit because fight the aircraft is going down. Yeah, the trim has fixed that. It's going to increase my engine a little bit. At some stage I do need to start slowing down. I'll be honest, not sure what stage that is. You can also see that we're now entering the cloud, which appears to be over at least this area. I'm hoping by the time we reach the airport the cloud will have dissipated, otherwise we're going to be landing without knowing where the runway is, which may be an interesting video at least, but not great for me. So we've got another 13 or so miles until we hit the entry point. Okay, so I've noticed that the red lines down there are normally the entry point of where you want to be approaching the airport. So I'm going to begin to slow down and then I'm going to begin to descend a little bit. I think it's the other side of this hill. This could be incredibly awkward for me to manage because the visibility is going to be very poor by the looks of it. Somewhere over this hill, I think, is the airport. So I'm going to continue to reduce my airspeed. I want to make sure that I don't stall. And I think I'm going to begin the entry pattern to the airport. The airport has not yet given me any more instructions. I'm descending a little bit too much here, so I'm just going to increase my airspeed. Try and climb a little bit. Very paranoid. Yeah, so it looks like the entry point begins around this corner, so I'm going to have to swing left, then right again, and swing into the pattern entry of the airport. So I'm just going to take... So if you look on the engine dial there, the second meter along on the bottom left, you can see where I'm increasing or decreasing the throttle. I'm using a Thrustmaster Hotus Warthog throttle and joystick. So I'm using the throttle to reduce the engine speed, so I'm down at 5 there. Because I'm hoping to reduce my airspeed. I'm also having to fight the aircraft, as you might be able to see. I'm wobbling all over the place. It's because of the wind. So I am landing in the storm here. So this is Storm Ellen. I'm trying to land in the storm. I'm at Donegal. I'm approaching the airport here. It looks like it's behind this big hill, which is kind of... a lot of this stuff is obscured in clouds, unfortunately. I'm just going to increase my throttle and nose up a little bit. This aircraft doesn't, unfortunately, have some of the dials that I'm used to, so I can't, for example, see my horizon to see if... I'm not even sure if it has an indicator of vertical speed, so I can't see if I'm increasing or decreasing in vertical speed, so if I'm dropping in the air. You might see that the camera... well, the cockpit is moving all over the place. That's not me moving my head in the real world. You can see my head moving in the real world. And that's the aircraft is getting buffeted around, probably because I'm flying in high wind next to some hills, and the wind tends to have some pretty funny patterns there. So I think I need to keep going left here and then turn right and actually enter the pattern entry. The airport is off to that direction. So I'm going to head over this lake. Unfortunately, I don't know the name of these hills or this area. I just know I'm in Donegal area in Northern Ireland. Turning slightly to the right, so I'm going to have to turn pretty much hard right into the pattern entry if I've got my angle of approach right. I think I'm not 100% here, but I think I do. Just make sure I'm not too low with these trees. I don't think so. I'm just going to increase my engine speed a little bit because I can see that my airspeed is decreasing. I really, in an ideal world, want to get my airspeed to about 80 when I'm landing, I think. But it's a bit too early for that. And I think I'm a little bit low at the moment, so I probably want to be about 1,500 feet, I think, I'm guessing. I'm going to climb a little bit to 1,500 or so. This is such a beautiful area, look at this. Love to live in one of those houses or one of these farms. So, such a pretty area. Okay, so I think I actually need to fly off down this direction through the clouds, which is scary, back towards those red indicators. The red indicators are the equivalent of instrument landing system. In some advanced aircrafts, as I understand it, you can have a guide that guides you in. In this game, it kind of shows you just on the heads-up display, I guess, on the screen, basically, where the ideal window would be to guide yourself in. Unfortunately, I am actually approaching it from the wrong angle by the looks of it, so it looks like you're supposed to swing around from the other side of this hill, straight forward, then turn hard left, keep going down, then turn hard left again, and then land. I'm going to have to do this in clouds over what looks like a forest. So this is going to be an interesting experience for me, and you guys might well get to laugh at me here because I might well make an enormous mess of this. See if air traffic control can tell me anything. How do I actually get here? No, I can't communicate with them at the minute, unfortunately, and I don't have time to fix that. I think that's an issue with the game. I think I'm possibly clicked into the wrong window. I'll try that again. Request aircraft directions. There we go. Okay, so I'm 7 miles out. Now I just need to be careful with this hill. I do not want to land, I say land in quotes, into the hill. You can see what I mean with the cloud now. So I'm effectively losing all visibility at the moment. So I've just got to make sure that I don't hit these trees. Getting buffeted around by the wind as well. Okay. So, there's a lake down there. Okay, I'm just going directly overhead a lake. If I look down, I can really see the lake. There we go. Try not to get too distracted. So I think I'm going to need to enter the pattern entry. At this stage, I'm going to start to slow down. We want to get the airspeed to about 80, which is where I know we're still too high. So we're going to slow down a little bit. We're going to be careful not to stall out. Okay, so it does look like this is going to be a limited visibility landing because of the look around at the clouds there. We unfortunately head into clouds and then back out of clouds when we actually reach the airport, I do believe. But yeah, we're gonna have a moment where we actually come out of the clouds slightly and gain some sun, which should give us a little bit of visibility, and then we're gonna head back into the clouds, it appears. So now I'm gonna start reducing off the throttle. As I begin to slow down, the wind is definitely battering us around a little bit more, which does make sense when you think about it. The less engine RPMs we have, I guess the wind might take more effect on us as a moving object. Okay, so the plan here is I slow down to around about 80, and then we're gonna enter the pattern entry. Now the pattern entry has turned blue because we're now approaching the right speed, so it will alternate between blue and red. So red can mean we're either too fast or we're too slow, so we should probably aim to stay at about 80 during this time. That's 80 kilometers per hour. Now that's quite slow, so if you were to see this in the real world, it would kind of look like we were perhaps flying a little bit too slow, and it may look like we're going to crash. It just means we're not going to stall. Like, we would stall if we hit between 60 to 40 kilometers per hour. That's where we would be getting too slow to maintain ourselves in the air, and we would just begin to nosedive and probably crash. So I am almost certainly going to hit too fast as we go around this corner. Actually, it might balance it out because we're losing a little bit of airspeed by turning. So we're now turning into the pattern approach. The airport I can see off to my left, so it's actually by the water in Donegal. A very pretty area. You can see some houses down here. I'm gonna try not to get too distracted, I'm sorry. We did actually fly over some wind turbines to our right there, by the looks of it, in the distance. Okay, so we're actually too slow. So, we're very close to stalling here. We're just gonna ramp up our engines to maximum. Okay, there we go. Okay, so we're clear to land on runway 21. We're too fast. I would rather be too fast than too slow, to be honest, because we almost got to the point there where we stalled out. That was my fault. One thing that we do have is our flaps. I think this aircraft has some degree of flaps. They do not look very effective. We're just going to reduce our airspeed even more, and we are actually going to put our flaps down as well, assuming the aircraft has any kind of reflective flaps. Now, naturally we come down. I'm going to keep reducing gradually my engine speed. And this is where we need to dance to a really delicate balance of not falling too far down, so not losing too much vertical height, also not going too fast. At the moment we're a little bit too low, but it's almost perfect. This is where I need to increase my throttle because I need to nose up a little bit, keep myself at about 80. Very, very delicate balance here. There you see, I've gone too fast there, so I reduce off the throttle a little bit. Looks like we're almost at the right angle. We're a little bit too high now. We're going too fast, so we're just going to ease off the throttle a little bit. We're going to very gently pivot around the corner. I feel like Ross from Friends now, by the way. Pivot, pivot. So we're going to very gently ease ourselves around here. We are too fast on this final one. We're at perfect speed now. And because we're gonna have to pull up, there is a chance we will. So we just need to keep turning left. Sorry, I'm trying to concentrate on what I'm doing here. We're about 70 miles an hour now, which is a little bit too low. We pivoted left too much, so we're just going to quickly turn right. We're going too fast, so we're just gonna change that. I'm so nervous. We're slowing down nicely now, so we're just gonna ease off the throttle entirely, and we're gonna try okay. Oh, okay, in real world we would have survived that. I think we would have definitely damaged the airplane though, because we would have ended up in a situation. I'm just going to take myself off the runway slightly, so just in case anybody else is trying to land here. So we would have damaged the left hand side of the runway. If I just put my brake on there, make sure my throttle's off here, and I'm just going to go back into first person view and just kill the engine. Okay, we should come to a full stop here. Just use the parking brake as well, a little bit. There we go. Okay, so we made it. So, yeah, in real life, we would have damaged the left wing there, and also probably hurt our own bottom a little bit. But we did. We made it. We made it. We legitimately, I think, made it, having screwed up our aircraft through Storm Ellen from Liverpool, across all kinds of different locations, which I did write down, but unfortunately I lost the list. So I'm gonna have to go and recreate that. So I'm gonna go and edit this video now. Should I request taxied parking? Probably not worth it now. I'm kind of just sat off the runway anyway. So at the moment there's no other planes landing here. I can't see any other players, but we made it through the storm. The storm wasn't too bad, but I would not recommend flying this kind of plane across, say, the English Channel, through Wales, through Ireland, etc., in that kind of weather. It was at times a little bit nerve-wracking. So thank you very much for joining me on this trip. Feel free to write in the comments about other locations you'd like to see. Bye.